Welcome to Rajya Sabha Television. You're watching Rajya Sabha News with me, Frank Pereira. Here are the headlines. Rajya Sabha adjourned till March 5th. On the last day of the first part of the budget session, Chairman Venkaiah Naidu expresses anguish over the functioning of the House, calls for improvement when Parliament meets again. Floor leaders of various parties object to the social media posts using objectionable language against the chairman, reiterate full faith and confidence in Chairman M. Venkaiah Naidu. And Rajya Sabha continues discussion on Union Budget. Finance Minister Arun Jaitley responds to the discussion. Well, the first part of the 245th session of the Rajya Sabha concluded on Friday and the House was adjourned till March 5th to meet for the second half of the budget session. Giving details of the proceedings in the session, Chairman Venkaiah Naidu expressed disappointment over frequent disruptions in the House, stating that the House lost 10 hours due to forced adjournments. He also appealed to all the members to contribute to the smooth functioning and constructive debate in the House.
We are coming to the end of the first part of the 245th session of the Rajya Sabha today, and we shall be meeting again after about a month to continue our discussions on the budget. I must confess that I am deeply pained at the way this session has progressed. As a chairman, it is my responsibility because at the end of the day, I am accountable to the people. They will see how the House is conducted, how discussions have went on. I was deeply disturbed is the utter disregard for the parliamentary procedure and the unruly behaviour so unbecoming of the high position we occupy in the society as parliamentarians. Dear members, the question I have been asking myself and probably many Indians watching us on the television screens would be thinking of is this: can we ever make our parliament an effective instrument of change through informed debate, constructive criticism and orderly proceedings? I was hoping that we shall collectively strive to uphold and maintain the dignity, sanctity and supremacy of parliament as we had pledged in 2012 to commemorate the 60th anniversary of the sitting of the parliament. I shall still keep hoping that we shall exercise the necessary restraint and behave with appropriate severity and dignity. I find it sad commentary that on the functioning that we had lost nearly 10 hours during this brief session due to disruptions and forced adjournments. We could not have question hour on 5 days and also no 0 hour on 5 days. Dear members, we certainly should not go in this manner any longer. I appeal to each one of you, please consider this as a sacred institution which should reflect the hopes and aspirations of 130 crore people. This is not aimed at any party, this party or that party. As far as the chair is concerned, I am concerned about the House. It is an institution that decides their destiny and charts the direction of national development. That's why people have high hopes on us. We are so privileged to be in this House because of the people's trust in us. We must use the opportunity wisely by debating, discussing and evolving solutions to a vast number of public concerns. Let us not have slanging matches between parties and stoop down to competing with each other on unparliamentary language or behaviour. And we meet again in March. It's my fervent hope and earnest appeal to each one of you that we shall turn a new leaf in our Parliament's history through orderly, informed and constructive debates. Friends, honourable members, over the last 2 days, I have been telling floor leaders of the quality debate on the motion of thanks to the President, either from this side or at that side. And I am very much impressed the way the debate was initially conducted and the contribution made positively from that side and also critically from this side in their own way. They have got every right, and we have such a good parliamentarians here who has the capacity to articulate, capacity to argue and also capacity to put forth their point of view. That being the case, and we have such a talented material in all sides, why should we lose the opportunity to have the debate? That's only my concern. Other things and all, each individual actions and all, I am not going to make any comment, and whatever has happened, that has been clarified in the morning, so I am not even touching that. And then some people have given notice, that notice has been taken note, that has been already announced, and there was some mention about Rajya Sabha by Sri Derek O'Brien. That also has been inquired into, and a report has been given. It has been sent to the honourable members also. There was some power failure. So, friends, I only request every one of you, please keep the prestige, the decorum of this august House. We are supposed to be the elders. So keep that in mind and then respond in such a manner so that the prestige of the House goes up. I am keen that such atmosphere and quality debates will become a regular feature like we had in the recent past.
Meanwhile, replying to the discussion on the union budget, Finance Minister Arun Jaitley rebutted the opposition's criticism on various measures listed in the budget. Highlighting the flaws in the UPA regime's management of the Indian economy, he said that the NDA government, despite inheriting a lot of fiscal problems, had kept the economy on track.
और आप किस व्यवस्था में छोड़ के गए 5.3 एंड 6.3 और आपके जाते ही क्या हुआ 7.5% 8.2% 7.1% और जिसको स्लो डाउन ईयर कहते हैं स्ट्रक्चरल रिफॉर्म की वजह से 6.7% लुक हुज टॉकिंग आप 5.3 और 6.3 कि जीडीपी दो वर्ष छोड़ के गए हैं राइट टू फूड यानी फूड सब्सिडी इस साल 1,70,000 करोड़ है
प्लीज
और इसलिए अगर हम किसी भी सरकार में ये कार्यक्रम शुरू हुए हो ग्रामीण सड़कों पे जो खर्च होता था उससे कई गुना ज्यादा 27,000 करोड़ सालाना किसी भी लोकसभा सांसद से पूछ लीजिए उसके क्षेत्र में कितना खर्च हो रहा है गांव को सड़क से जोड़ देना गांव के भीतर घर मिल जाना गांव के अंदर शौचालय बन जाना स्वच्छ भारत और शौचालय का जो निर्माण हुआ है पिछले 3-4 वर्षों में जिस गति के ऊपर देश में बढ़ा है वो अपने आप में एक नया इतिहास लिख रहा है
Well, Rajya Sabha resumed the discussion on the Union Budget 2018-19 on Friday. Initiating the discussion, Samajwadi Party MP Neeraj Shekhar termed the budget anti-poor. TMC member Derek O'Brien raised 12 questions for Railway Minister Piyush Goyal on the rail budget. He also targeted the government on GST. Left and NCP members raised the issue of decrease in allocation of money for education in the budget.
हर एक नागरिक के पानी का इंतजाम हो सके नहीं तो उसमें क्या हो रहा है
जब एक पकौड़ा बेचने वाला अपना पेट काट कर अपने बच्चे को पढ़ाता है उसको इंजीनियर बनाता है उसको डॉक्टर बनाता है उसको सीए बनाता है तब वो क्या चाहता है कि उसका बेटा भी उसके बगल में खड़ा होकर पकौड़ा बेचे प्रधानमंत्री बन सकते हैं चाय बेचने वाला का बेटा प्रधानमंत्री बन सकता है लेकिन प्रधानमंत्री चाहते हैं कि पकौड़ा बेचने वाला बेटा पकौड़ा बेचने वाला बने
जीएसटी जितना हायर नंबर रहेगा उतना खराब और जितना लो नंबर रहेगा उतना अच्छा तो लॉस ड्यू टू जीएसटी हमारा बंगाल में सबसे लोएस्ट लॉस 580 करोड़ गुजरात का लॉस 1100 करोड़ बिहार का लॉस 1000 करोड़ Karnataka lost 2,000 crores. So the system is not ready for GST, sir.
Right to education, which has we have been implementing for the last almost one decade, it has become very ineffective because every year the allocation for education is proportionally decreasing. And because of that, our claim that we can develop our youth as our major source of income, major source of wealth of the country for the coming decades. It is becoming a complete failure.
The budget talks about setting up of these chain of schools. On the other side, it cuts the allocations of Kendriya Vidyalayas and Jawaharlal Navodaya Vidyalayas. In fact, sir, even as far as the higher education space is concerned, the total budgetary allocations for IITs has been decreased from 8,224 crores to 6,326 crores in 2018-19. So there is a cut also in the IIMs and the UGCs.
What is crony socialism, sir? What is stigmatized capitalism? Yes. Does the government have any understanding? This is where I am calling you are suffering from ideological bankruptcy. You are suffering from ideological hypocrisy. And that's what I am saying. If you talk about stigmatized capitalism, what do you mean by stigmatized capitalism? It is you who are building crony capitalism, corporate capitalism in this country. And that is what your budget reflects.
महंगाई के जहाँ तक सवाल है तो ये सब लोग बार बार ये सवाल पूछ रहे हैं। अदर नीरज जी ने सब नहीं पूछा कि जो पेट्रोल डीजल का जाम जो विश्व बाजार में गिरे उसका कोई फायदा क्यों नहीं मिल पा रहा है। तीन साल से हम सब पूछ रहे हैं, चार साल से, और सचमुच उसका फायदा 75 रुपए प्रति लीटर आज की तारीख में पेट्रोल है इस समय दिल्ली में, और 64 रुपए का डीजल है। इससे महंगाई रुक ही नहीं सकती, क्योंकि उसका सीधे असर महंगाई पर होता है। तो इसके लिए सरकार जो है कुछ ना कुछ इतने दिन उन्होंने किया, लेकिन अब कितना फायदा कंज्यूमर को पास ऑन होता है उपभोक्ता को, ये बताने की कृपा वित्त मंत्री को जरूर करनी चाहिए।
The Union Territory's resources has been affected considerably by various factors like GST, ban on bar license on highways and ban on real estate sector. On one side, the expenditure has increased due to the implementation of seventh pay commission recommendations, and on another side, the income has come down.
Constitution में लिखा हुआ है कि every state shall have one high court. That high court का आज तक नहीं आया है. Some expenses other you start giving it, but never some sympathy came from you. ये जरा सोचना सोच कीजिए, high court देना शुरू कीजिए. अगर कौन सबर कर रहे हम लोग सबर कर रहे
आपने हम पर उम्मीदें लगाई हैं, हम आपकी उम्मीदों पर पूरा खरा उतरेंगे और आने वाले दिनों में ये सारी चीजें हम पूरी करने पर तत्पर हैं, चाहे स्वास्थ्य का होगा, चाहे जन के कृषि का होगा, चाहे किसान का होगा, चाहे जन के अच्छे पढ़े लिखे नौजवान का होगा, हम बेरोजगारी को दूर करने का भी प्रयास हर प्रकार कर सकते हैं।
Floor leaders of major parties in the Rajya Sabha today strongly objected to a Facebook post using objectionable language against the chairman. The leaders asserted that Chairman M. Venkaiah Naidu is conducting proceedings of the House, giving opportunities to all to raise issues, and they have full faith in him. They also appealed to the member concerned to apologize to the chair for bringing down the dignity of Parliament by making his opinion vocal on social media.
माननीय चेयरमैन साहब, हम सबको इस चेयर पर विश्वास है और हम लोग सम्मान भी चेयर के करते हैं। कल श्रीमन फेसबुक पे इस सदन के एक माननीय सदस्य ने माननीय चेयर के लिए कुछ ऐसे शब्द लिख दिए जो शब्द संसदी नहीं है, जो शब्द किसी प्रकार नहीं लिखने चाहिए, क्योंकि हम लोग को पूरा अधिकार है चेयर हमसे कुछ भी कह दें, हमें जो कहना चेयर से कमरे में कह दें, लेकिन इस तरह फेसबुक या सोशल मीडिया पर जाने में इस सदन की गरमा गिरती है, कुर्सी की गरमा गिरती है। तो मेरा मैं इस बात को कह रहा हूँ, वो माननीय सदस्य से मैं कहूँगा कि वो चेयरमैन से खेल प्रकट कर लें, चेयरमैन से माफ़ी मांग लें, और हम सब जानते हैं कि आप पे पार्शियलिटी होने का सवाल ही नहीं उठता, हम सबको न्याय मिलता है, ये मेरा।
हम सब सदन के अंदर चेयर के सम्मान के साथ हम लोग कार्यवाही में सब लोग भाग लेते हैं। मेरा ये आग्रह है कि संसद में आपस में हमारे राजनीतिक दलों के एक दूसरे से वैचारिक मतभिन्नताएं हो सकती हैं, राजनीतिक दलों की कार्यवाही पे एक दूसरे पे आक्षेप कर सकते हैं, पर जहां तक चेयर का सवाल है, हम सब लोग चेयर से बंधे हुए हैं सर, और इसलिए जिन भी सदस्यों ने फेसबुक पे या सोशल मीडिया में इस प्रकार का उपयोग किया है, निश्चित रूप से सदन की भी अवमानना है और संसदीय परंपरा के भी ये खिलाफ है। इसलिए जो नरेश जी ने कहा है, मैं आग्रह करूंगा कि उनको ये खेद व्यक्त करना चाहिए,
क्योंकि फेसबुक हमारे बस का है नहीं, ना हम जानते हैं ना पढ़ते हैं कभी, लेकिन मैं तो अभी इनसे सुन रहा हूँ। बहुत अफसोस की बात है कि इस तरह की चीज़ें फेसबुक पे आ जाएं और चेयर पे, कोई भी चेयर और लिस्ट ऑन चेयरमैन, इसके हम पूरी निंदा करते हैं और मेरे ख्याल में हर पूरे सदन को इससे डिसएसोसिएट करना है।
The Honorable Chairman of the Rajya Sabha gives us enough opportunities to discuss any grievance we have with him. Going with these issues, we can always talk to the chairman in confidence. We do not need to go to any part of the social media to express ourselves. We clearly want to tell you this, sir.
Thank you.
Well, that's it on this newscast. Good night.